Hello and a big namaste to all the viewers on the Saffron Box. My name is Yamini Sharma and today in this video I shall be talking about the month of September 2020. What are going to be the major planetary transits? What's going to be the movement in the skies, in the heavens this month? And what is going to be the impact on all the 12 signs, all the 12 ascendants? Right, so I shall also be putting up timestamps as you all have been requesting, and I do that regularly for all my videos. I shall be putting up the timestamps for all these signs in the description box as well as in the comment section. In the description box also you would find my mail ID, that is thesaffronbox@gmail.com, where you can touch base with me for personal consultations or in case you are interested in taking up any classes, learning astrology, etc. For the benefit of the viewers, I would like to tell you all that I take up classes, whether it is basic topics or advanced topics. So I take up tutorials from time to time in case you're interested in learning the Vedic science of Jyotish. You can actually touch base with me for further details. Right, so before I go ahead, I would also request you, in case you are a first time viewer here, do not forget to subscribe before you leave. And if you like the content, of course, a thumbs up is what you all have to do. Right, so I'll begin with the video. Let me go through the planetary transits first. What is going to be the movement this entire month? So in this month, you know, we see two major planets getting back to direct motion. So we have Saturn. Saturn is going to be direct in its own sign of Capricorn by the end of the month. Then we have Jupiter. Jupiter was also retrograde till now in the sign of Sagittarius. And by the 13th of September, we'll find Jupiter again back in direct motion in its own house of Sagittarius. So this is a major moment when Jupiter in the sign of Sagittarius or Dhanu goes direct, and Saturn or Shani in the sign of Makar or Capricorn again becomes direct. So this is like a reinforcement of whatever these two planets are to do, are wanting to do in their own signs. So this is a major movement. Then apart from that, we also have Mars getting into retrogression within its sign of Aries. So this is also, you know, Mars is the planet of energy. Mars is your desire. Mars is your Ichha as such. And when Mars gets into retrograde motion, it basically tells us that, you know, you need to go back, take a step back, reevaluate what are you actually wanting to do, what do you actually want to put your energy into, etc. Right, and then of course we have the other planets like Sun moving into the sign of Virgo in the by the middle of the month. Then we also have Mercury becoming exalted in the sign of Virgo, again a very good movement, because Mercury exaltation again gives a boost to all the things which Mercury represents. So you find especially, you know, people who have a Mercury Lagna, or you have major planets in the sign of Gemini or Virgo, or in case you have a lot of planets in the Mercury Nakshatras, you see this impact coming onto you. And of course we have Venus. Venus very quickly is going to be touching on two signs. So it's going to be transiting into the sign of Cancer at the beginning of the month, and thereafter by the end of the month it moves out and goes to Leo. So Venus is making these two quick hops within the month of September. Then of course we have Rahu and Ketu. They are changing signs. Rahu is moving out of Gemini into Taurus, and Ketu is moving out of Sagittarius into the sign of Scorpio on the 23rd. I have already made a video both in English as well as in Hindi. I have put the Hindi video on the Hindi channel. You can find the links in the description box again for that, as well as in the timestamps in the cards somewhere above in this video as well. So these are the major movements. And what do these movements talk about? See, with one thing which I would really like to point out here is, you know, Mars retrogression. Mars being retrograde in motion within the sign of Aries basically gives us time, gives us opportunity to step back and evaluate everything, as I said. And then from there, from the sign of Aries, Mars aspects Venus, which is going to be in the sign of Cancer. Then we also have Saturn aspecting the sign of Cancer from the sign of Capricorn. So Saturn is giving a direct aspect to Venus. Okay, then this entire month we have the Artha trine being activated. The Artha trine, that is the trine which talks about our resources, our money, what are our material possessions, how do we go about our work, what is our daily routine, how productive are we, how do we put our resources, our means to good use. So when we talk about this Artha trine in the sign of Taurus, I mean, I am talking about the natural Kalpurush Kundali, in the second house, in the sign of Taurus, we have Rahu moving in. Then in the sixth house, we have Mercury getting exalted in its own house. And then of course, in the 10th house, we have Saturn, which is there, which has been there for the last 8 months. But then Saturn also gets back into direct motion in the sign of Capricorn. So we have major planets here in the Artha trine. And that too in good dignity, that too in good strength as such, regaining their strength, especially by the second half of the month. So this actually gives in a major boost to the Artha trine. So as we all know, you know, going by the common scenario as well, now we are all going to be moving back towards realigning our resources, towards taking care of our cash, towards taking care of our resources, understanding what is going to work for us in the long run, what kind of redoing of investments do you need, are you using your resources enough, are you using them optimally, are you putting your money to hard work like the way you are doing your hard work, you know, are you quite, you know, alert and disciplined in your daily routine. Are you using your time every day properly? And what kind of karma are you doing? So the Artha trine talks about all this. And I'll begin with the impact on all the 12 signs. I'll start with Aries. So the first sign, the first ascendant which I'm going to be talking about, Aries. You know, this is the natural Kalpurush Kundali anyways. So with Aries, there is going to be a lot of retrospection, a lot of thinking which goes in your mind, because you have a retrograde Mars in the ascendant itself, and this retrogression is here to stay for some time. So this also gives you health concerns. You evaluate as to what kind of health issues have been bothering you. You try to understand what kind of changes you got to make in your daily routine. How do you take care of your health in case you are prone to injuries, cuts, these kind of issues, or any blood related issues? I think this is a time to be very, very careful regarding your health. So you get all calculative, you get very analytical and move towards perfection in your daily routine. You try to understand what is going to work for you, try to understand your own health, your bodily constitution, and then accordingly work towards your health. We have with Venus being in the sign of Cancer in the fourth house, there is going to be expenditure, there is going to be a lot of upheaval. When it comes to domestic issues, there could be coldness in relationships within your family. There could be issues at home which rake up unpleasant feelings, negative feelings, old memories, something which you don't want to deal with, something which you try to avoid dealing with. Right? So this is going to be a major drain of your energy this entire month, as I see it. There could also be, expenditure on lot of things, you know, around the house, on relatives, on relationships. It is important that you spend your money on good causes rather than being impulsive, because Mars casting a fourth aspect on Venus could also make you spend on impulse, you know, spend immediately without thinking. So this is a time to hold on to your resources, understand what is going to work for you, understand how time can be saved, how can you be more productive, how do you take care of your health, and more importantly, what is going to bring you mental peace. That is something which is very, very important for Aries Lagna. Now moving on to the sign of Taurus. For Taurus, if we see by the end of the month, Rahu is going to be transiting into your Lagna. A very positive moment, actually. Rahu gets exalted here. And then we have Ketu in the seventh house by the end of the month. See, this month sees a break in alliance of Jupiter and Ketu. So your Jupiter stays in the eighth house, Ketu comes to the seventh. The dispositor of Ketu, Mars, is retrograde in motion in the 12th house. This could bring in major relationship challenges. There could be problems with respect to relationships. I think you need to deal with all things around you with a lot of honesty, with a lot of care. Those of you who are going through a rough patch in your marriage, you find that there's a lot of incompatibility of late. There have been issues which you have been dealing with. I think this could be a point where you could be a little impulsive and decide one way or the other. You could decide on breaking out of a relationship, whether it's a marital relationship or a relationship, you know, you're involved with somebody for a long time. So this could make you take a call on a lot of relationship issues. And this month is very crucial for that. In fact, this is actually a time to halt, to step back and see where you're headed in the future. I think this is a lovely month for you to get into a little introspective mode as well, before Rahu energies actually kick in, all out in your ascendant. So I think the first half of the month is something which you can use to actually align up things around you, work on your relationships, see what works, see what doesn't, cut out the unnecessary stuff which is taking away your time, which is taking away your energy, and mentally draining you out as well. This could be a time of expenditure on short travels, on creative arts. You could take up a new initiative as well. Venus, your Lagnesh, is in the third house. So this could actually be a booster to your creativity, to a booster to initiatives. So you could think of new ideas. You could think of taking up some new projects altogether. And it's very important that you use your intelligence, use your creativity in a very unbiased manner. Listen to what you feel rather than getting influenced with the environment around you. Then we move on to the third sign, that is Gemini. For Gemini, see, this month Rahu moves out of your ascendant, goes to the 12th. You have Mercury, the Lagnesh, getting exalted in the 4th house. A very positive sign. But you also have Mars, which is your 11th lord, which is your Labhesh, getting back in retrograde motion. But the good part is that we have the Lagnesh in exaltation. So this could actually, make you a little more practical towards the efforts which you do. Takes you towards a very pragmatic approach. You decide what is actually going to work for you and you focus on that as well. This is also a time when you could feel a little insecure about things around you. So you feel a little insecure in your social circle. You're not very sure as to what gains are you getting, who's with you, who's not. So all these kind of doubts could creep in into your mind. And you could sometimes behave a little erratically, behave in a little, you know, insecure way. So time to check your emotions, time to keep your things in place. And with Mercury getting exalted in your fourth house, I think you should be able to do that as well. So see what your resources are. Venus is in the second house in the sign of Cancer. It's getting aspected by Mars. It's getting aspected by Saturn also. So Saturn is in the eighth house for you. There could be old inheritance issues which come into picture. For some of you who are going through a favorable time for inheritance, I think this could be a time where you gain some cash, where you come into some money as well. So this is a time to focus on family issues, focus on resources, focus on your home, your conveyances, etc. Right? So you could be taking a good decision this month. You should be able to use your intelligence very well. Then we move on to the sign of Cancer, the fourth sign. See, for Cancer, Venus comes into your ascendant and stays here for a few days, in fact most of the month, and then moves out into your second house. Then we have Saturn in the seventh house. We have Jupiter becoming direct in the sixth house, with Saturn also becoming direct in the seventh by the end of the month. This is a time period when a lot of, you know, emotional upheaval could take place for you. A lot of emotions stir up. There could also be some amount of coldness in relationships, which actually makes you think deep and think emotionally. So you could get emotional about a lot of relationships, dig out past issues, and, you know, basically spend a lot of time in memories being sentimental. So while you do all of this, there could be some loss of peace of mind as well. So because Venus is your fourth lord as well, sitting in the ascendant, so this is a time to keep your cool, keep your emotions under control. Do not exhibit too much of you know, emotions or negativity to people. So think through, try to think what you're doing, try to think about how you're going to react, because relationships are going to pose a problem towards you. But Mercury in the third, in an exalted state, could actually help you out. This is a time to focus on your creative ideas, focus on new works, new initiatives, etc. Rather than brooding over old relationships and old wounds which you've got from relationships, I think leave that out and focus on the new. Focus on what is going to come your way. By the end of the month, Rahu is also going to be transiting into your 11th house. Again, a good signal. Again, a good indication for you as such. Then, you could also see that some amount of travel is coming up. So, some amount of, you know, traveling, or there could be time spending on communication. As I said, I have mentioned creative arts, creative ideas. So travel expenditures could happen. You could spend a lot of time on social media platforms. But be very careful about how you're communicating. That's, I think, very, very important. New opportunities could also come up. So you find that your you know, new opportunities are coming up. You get to you know, see new avenues for growth as well. So utilize this time rather than, you know, focusing on things which are not working out too well for you. Then we move on to the next sign of Leo. See, for Leo, your Lagnesh Sun is moving out of your first house into the second house of Virgo, where it's also going to you know, conjoin with Mercury, which is in going to be in exaltation. good sign, a good time for you to take up financial issues, take up financial decisions. You'll be very practical. This month is going to be very nice, very good for you in terms of your resources, how you're managing them, how you're acquiring more resources, how you're going to use things around you, opportunities around you. Your fifth house sees Jupiter coming back into direct motion. Saturn in the sixth is getting direct by the end of the month. So overall, this tells you that you're going to be using your intelligence well. You're going to be connecting with your children very well. Those of you who are looking at gains from stock markets, equity, etc., could also see a favorable time. You could see some gains coming your way. You could see some positive movement, at least a positive trend of growth in your resources, right? And while all this is happening, wealth wise this is okay, but there could be career issues which take away your time, which take away your mental peace. So career issues could bother you. There could be people from the social circle, people whom you know, who somehow put doubts in you. You are not able to trust them. You are not able to understand how to deal with certain people. So these issues at work could actually trouble you. You've got to be a little more careful about how you're using your luck also. So I think this is something which you need to be careful about, how you're using your intelligence, what kind of decisions are you taking. Are you taking proper professional advice before taking any major decisions? I think that is also very, very important. So it's time to be a little more communicative. It's time to be a little more open to others' ideas. Be a little more receptive and then carry on with things, especially major decisions which are regarding your career, which are regarding new opportunities in work as well as in business, right? Then we move on to the next sign, which is Virgo. Virgo sees a good time because you have Mercury as well as Sun together in the first house, in the ascendant. Mercury is getting exalted. Sun is joining up there. There's a Buddha Aditya Yog temporarily. Mercury being there in its own exaltation sign also gives Bhadra Yog. So this is a lovely combination. You use your communication, you use your speech, your various talents to influence people around you, and you're going to be you come out satisfied. You're able to use things in a better manner. Use your luck, use your charm, sometimes use your abilities to tide over a lot of situations positively, right? Your communication skills could actually make way for you, could work in your favor. So how you communicate, how you're working around people, how you're connecting with people, how you're connecting with people at work, with your boss, all this comes into picture, and you see a good time this month. However, sometimes you may feel that you're running out of luck. You are wanting to make use of a certain opportunity, but then something comes up and you just lose an opportunity by a very little margin. So this is something which you could see troubling you from time to time, especially in the first half of the month. So be a little careful and patient, and in case you are looking at some new opportunities coming up, I suggest by the end of the month, if you take decisions regarding that, that will be better. This is also a time to express yourself, basically. Use your communication, talk it out with people. Whatever you want, express it. And that is what is going to help you out more. This is also a time where you see a lot of people in your house, a lot of movement. A lot of people coming to meet you. There could be a family get together. There could be a lot of interaction within your family as well. So a lot of social interactions also coming up for you this very month. Then we see Libra. Libra, the seventh sign of the zodiac. What do we have for Libra? See, your Lagnesh is going to be in your 10th house majority of the month. And it's going to be aspected by Saturn, by Mars. Career issues could trouble you. Issues at work could trouble you. You could feel that you've just been pushed back at work because of some reason or the other. You were making progress, but then suddenly something happens and you're pushed back. So you were like, you know, you went two steps ahead and one step backwards. So career issues could bother you. It's time to handle your boss very, very tactfully. Those of you who are awaiting any communication or who are waiting for some kind of approval, this month could see some news. I'm not saying whether it's going to be good or bad, but there could be some kind of a news, some kind of communication which could come your way. This is also a time to take good care of your health, especially those of you who are prone to any kind of a genetic issue or there's some hereditary disease which you're dealing with. I think this is a time to keep your health under check. There could also be some travel which comes up, which is on the cards. So some short distance travels could also take up your time, where you take some initiative and travel for work, travel for business. That is something which I see for you this month. It's time to, reevaluate your ideas, reevaluate your thinking towards your career issues. I think this is a good month to, do all this. A time to utilize this transit in checking out career options, in checking out what actually gives you satisfaction in your work. So, a wonderful time to do that. Then we move on to the next sign of Scorpio. See, for Scorpio, we have the Lagnesh, that is Mars, retrograde in motion in the 6th house. So most of the month it's going to be retrograde in motion, and for the times to come as well. So Mars here could actually bring you into health issues. Those of you who have problems related to headaches or migraines, anything like that, or there could be chances of injury towards the head region. You have to be a little careful, right? So a lot of effort is what you put into your daily routine. Everyday effort increases. Sometimes you could also feel a little fatigued, little tired of whatever you've been doing every day. So time to, give yourself a little break. Take a break from your routine. I think that's very, very important for your overall well-being. And break out of your daily routine. Change and bring in some entertainment. Bring in some change in your life as such. Relationships also are a major concern for you. You could feel that, people are a little distant from you. Right, even your close ones are not able to understand you as well. So there could be certain amount of coldness in relationships. You could feel neglected. You could feel a little stressed out because of people's behavior. So it's time to actually use your tact, use your communication properly in this entire month to deal with your relationships. So use your, it's time also to use your social network. Use your professional network to achieve what you want. Network with people. Get to understand how you can, benefit with the opportunities which are going to come up your way in due time. So, wonderful month for Scorpio Ascendant in terms of career opportunities, new growth avenues. But relationships and your health could be a point which could actually, make you worried for some time, especially the first half of the month. Then we have Sagittarius, the next sign, the ninth sign of the zodiac, Sagittarius or Dhanu. See, for you, Ketu moves out of your first house of your ascendant into your 12th, Then Rahu moves out from the 7th to the 6th house towards Taurus. Jupiter is in your ascendant, and this month, by the 13th, Jupiter becomes direct in motion. You could feel a boost in your confidence. You could feel that yes, opportunities are coming your way. Why so? Because Sun and Mercury together by the second half of the month come together in your 10th house. And this could bring in, you know, when Sun comes in the 10th house, it's like the 9th house lord and the 10th house lord, that is Mercury, joining up together. This makes a temporary dharma karma adhipati yoga as well, produces a raj yoga of some sort as well. So work wise you get to shine, work wise you get to see new opportunities. You try and understand what kind of environmental change is there at work, and you adapt quickly in terms of the environmental changes at work. You have Rahu in your 6th house by the end of the month, which is again a big booster to your opportunities around you. Growth options, your Upache Bhava has Rahu here, and then your Sun and Mercury are together in the 10th. Also, Saturn is there in the 2nd house, which is again, a big kick to the Upache Bhava as well as to the Artha trine in your case. So you get to manage your resources, you get to understand how your wealth is going to work for you. Those of you who are looking at new opportunities to invest or start something of their own could use this time to do so. Mercury makes you use your communication abilities to the fullest. You're able to communicate your thoughts with clarity. You're able to put your points across to people properly as well. This is also a good month for relationships in your case. Though, with your spouse, I would say that you need to be a little careful, especially if you're a male Sagittarian. Because Venus, which is the actual karaka for your wife as such, is not in a very good state. Venus is getting aspected by Mars, by Saturn, and it's in your 8th house. So, people who are male Sagittarians, the Sagittarian men as such, need to be a little careful, because you could get into petty fights, which actually, rolls up into a bigger issue later on. So it's time to check how you communicate with your spouse, take care of her. Those of you who have any health issue as such, any hereditary issues with regard to, diabetes or hormonal issues, etc., also need to be very, very careful this entire month, right? This is also a very good month for those of you who want to go in for higher learning or want to pursue their spiritual growth. You want to spend time with the guru, you want to spend time in higher education, higher learning. This is a wonderful month for you to develop yourself in terms of spirituality, at least start walking on that path as well. Then we have Capricorn, the 10th sign of the zodiac. For Capricorn, you see Saturn, the Lagnesh, is becoming direct in motion by the end of the month though. You have Venus right in front in the 7th house. Then you also have Jupiter in the 12th house getting direct in motion. These are the major movements for you. You have your 4th lord, that is Mars, becoming retrograde in the 4th house itself. This could be a time of emotional upheaval for a lot of you. You could also feel a little frustrated with regard to, domestic peace. You are not so happy in relationships. You could feel that, you are not able to communicate properly to your spouse. People are not able to understand you at home. So this is a period of domestic unrest. So it's time to actually keep a low profile and not get too carried away, not get too impulsive and break ties with people around you or have fights with family members. So a very, very important piece of advice for you is to actually just keep a low profile and let things go. It's not necessary to react every time to each and every situation as such. Sometimes not reacting is also a reaction, right? So you need to keep your cool around things. This is a time for higher learning. I think your time is better utilized in learning new things, in learning new arts. Pursue your spiritual growth as such. Mercury is exalted in your ninth house. You could come across a good teacher. You could come across good learning opportunities which help you out in your path of growth. There could also be chances of travel. So those of you who are looking at traveling out of the country or traveling a little long distance, if not out of the country, you could see some opportunity to travel for a good cause also. So time to listen to your inner voice and not to be very impulsive as such. Then we also have the next sign of Aquarius, the 11th sign of the zodiac. See, for Aquarius, your Lagnesh is in the 12th house and it's becoming direct by the end of the month, that is Saturn. And in your 7th house, you have Sun, which was there. Sun is going to move out into your 8th house and join there with Mercury, which is going to be in the exalted sign of Virgo. So you have Sun and Mercury together in the 8th. You have Venus in the 6th house. That is not a very good place for Venus in the sign of Cancer, and especially being aspected by Saturn, by Mars. And this is going to be a little challenging period in terms of, you know, your overall health, your routine, workspace. This is going to be a challenging month as such. So take care of people around work. Be a little sensitive towards them. Do not be oversensitive to everything which comes across your way. So it's time to be a little tough mentally. Understand how things are going to work around your resources. Be a little practical. Your 10th Lord Mars is also, you know, in retrograde motion in the 3rd house. You could take initiative, but it could be in the wrong direction. You could take, you know, some kind of a project, some responsibility could come your way, but you may not feel so great about taking that responsibility. You may not feel so up to doing things. So this is a time to keep your motivation high and then carry on with things rather than getting bogged down, because this is going to be a challenging month. So this is time to actually keep your head cool and just move very practically. So focus more on your work. Focus more towards maintaining what you have to do at work. If you have any pending things related to your house construction, any vehicle related work, etc., this is a time to do it. Those of you who are pursuing higher education, I think this is going to be a good time. Those of you who are in research, in occult, such things, in hidden issues, hidden things, you know, you have interest in such things, research areas, etc., this is going to be a wonderful time. Those of you who have insurance money due from some place, or there could be windfall gains for those of you who have been, you know, waiting for long, who have, you know, there is some favorable dasha going on, you come into some windfall gains, come into unearned money. There could be some gifting also, or inheritance money, legacy money, which you come into. Then we move on to the last sign of the zodiac, that is Pisces. See, for Pisces, your Lagnesh is becoming direct in motion in the 10th house itself. That's Jupiter. Things could start improving a little in your professional space, at work, with your boss. Then you also have, you know, a wonderful Kendra, your 4th Lord, your 7th Lord, that is Mercury, is getting exalted in the 7th house itself. And Sun is joining up with Mercury, forming up a Buddha Aditya Yog. Both aspect your ascendant as well. A wonderful time for you to use your intelligence, use your creativity, use your personality to influence people, influence work, and carry on your projects with lot of ease. One. But the other thing, Venus is going to be in your fifth house in the sign of Cancer, aspected by Saturn from the 11th, aspected by Mars from the second house. There could be wasteful expenditure. There could be problems in your love life, in matters of the heart. So be a little careful there. Use your intelligence properly. Your children could demand a lot of attention from you. I think time to pay a lot of attention towards children. Those of you who are expecting or planning a family, I think this is a time to be a little careful there. Go ahead with the medical advice. Get yourself checked up from time to time. Use your speech carefully. Though your ascendant Lord is in a good state, your fourth Lord, seventh Lord, Mercury is in a good state, this is a time to use your speech very carefully within the family. Because what you say, words once spoken could actually hurt people around you and cause a lot of issues around you. So relationships are something which you need to be careful about. But marriage-wise, I think this is an okay month. Those of you who are looking at any alliance coming up, I think this could be a time where you will step into some kind of an opportunity to get married also. So that was it. All about the 12 signs, the 12 ascendants. I shall see you very soon in my next video. Till then, bye-bye. God bless. Thank you.